How's it going, everyone? It is Pangino here, and in this video I'm going to be covering a very quick Windows update which could potentially fix some of the larger issues that some Windows users are experiencing. This video is more specifically going to be covering a brand new Windows 11 update which has just launched, and if you happen to update your version of Windows and the issue isn't fixed, I'll also be covering a few different options that you can look into to potentially fix these errors with the main goal of helping you achieve a stable and fast system. This video is more of a PSA just to get this out to make sure that everyone is aware that this update is now live and you can access it on your system even if the update isn't automatically there. As the update has now been available for about a day or so, there have been reports that this has been fixing many people's issues with micro stuttering on certain games and many game crash issues for those running on Nvidia GPUs. So if you are experiencing issues with running games, games crashing, lower than expected performance, or micro stuttering, then installing this update could be a very good idea to get your system completely stable. Get Windows activated for a great price with WhoKeys. Use the links below for Windows 11, Windows 10, or Office. Apply code PAN20 at checkout for an additional 25% off. Secure payment options, including PayPal, are available. Once complete, just paste the key to activate Windows and remove the watermark. Windows 10 keys can also upgrade to Windows 11. Use the links in the description below, and thank you to WhoKeys for sponsoring. If you're looking to install this update to your system, if it's not already installed, take yourself down to the Windows button, go to Settings, go to the top right-hand side to Windows Update, or alternatively go to the bottom left-hand side and click Windows Update. If there are no updates currently available for your system, go to the top right-hand side to check for updates. The update we're looking for is KB5058499. As the main update is starting to roll out for most systems, you'll also be able to find these performance improvements in update KB5060842. When you're updating your system, if you don't see these two specific patches, that's completely fine. Just apply any and all updates that are available to you. If you happen to be making use of an older version of Windows 11, such as 22H2 or 23H2, you can still get many of the fixes that this update deploys on those older versions of Windows. The update file you're going to be looking for is KB5058502. On 22H2 or 23H2, you could also be looking for KB5060999. You don't need to do a massive update to 23H2 or 24H2, you just need that individual patch to get the performance improvements and fixes that we're discussing in this video. If the update doesn't show up, this could be that your system has already installed the update, or the standard release channel hasn't given you the update yet. An easy way to get access to this update as soon as possible is to check the option for get the latest updates as soon as they're possible, switch this to on, then select check for updates again. Once the update has finished installing to your system, go to the top right-hand side to restart now for the update to be fully applied. Just to make sure that we're now successfully up to date with all Windows updates, take yourself down to the Windows key once again, go to the Settings tab, the bottom left to Windows Update, and once again, just select Check for Updates just to make sure there is nothing outstanding or no new updates which are now available because you've just installed that one. Restart your PC and repeat the process until all updates are completed, and you're notified in the top left-hand side that you are completely up to date. To see if the update has already been installed to your system, head down to the Windows button, search for WinVir, and press Enter. If you're running on Windows 11 version 24H2, OS build 26100, 4202, or higher, the update has either just been installed to your system, or if the number is higher, that means that the update has been installed for quite some time. If the OS build is less than 26100, 4202, this might be an indication that the update is not yet currently applied to your system. If you are using Windows 11 22H2 or 23H2, just make sure that you are regularly checking the Check for Updates section, and you should be good to go. Once you have completely updated your system, you've checked that it's installed, what I would then recommend that you do, if you happen to have any specific applications or games that were giving you problems, boot into those games and retest them with the update completed. As mentioned, there are lots of reports of this potentially fixing micro stutter issues that many people have been experiencing and outright game crashes. Even if it's a game refusing to boot or crashing after 10 to 15 minutes, this update should have hopefully fixed most of those, if not all of those issues. If you still happen to be running into issues after this Windows update, it could be because it might not actually be Windows that is the issue. There are still a few things that you can do to check off absolutely everything to hopefully get you back on a stable system. Number one, if you're on an Nvidia GPU, I would highly recommend that you check out the video in the top right hand side of the screen now in the video card, or linked in the description below. This will show you how to fix the majority of Nvidia graphics driver issues which you could be experiencing, thinking it might be a Windows issue, or before this update, you might have have thought it was a GPU issue and this update could have fixed it. Alongside this, you could also look to repair when updating Windows to make sure that the operating system doesn't have any inconsistencies, missing or damaged files, which could potentially also be causing issues. And if you're looking to get started on that process, it's simple, quick, and easy to do, and you can also find that linked in the description down below. If you happen to be utilizing a brand new RTX 50 series GPU and you're still experiencing issues after applying this Windows update and potentially adjusting your Nvidia graphics drivers, there is an optional firmware update available for some RTX 50 series GPUs to fix potential black screen issues. If your GPU is supported by the firmware update, it is something that you can look into. I won't be covering it in this video because it is more of a niche fix, but it is something that you should be aware of if you are experiencing those issues. And for those of you that are using Intel 13th or 14th generation CPUs, there has been a few BIOS updates for the majority of these CPUs to help fix crashing issues, especially when it comes to playing games running on Unreal Engine, inconsistent performance over time with your system, and overall boosting the stability with these platforms. Please let me know if this has fixed any specific issues you were experiencing, if you happen to have any other tips or tricks, or could help out anyone else in the comments below that may be experiencing issues like this. Check out the video on screen, and I'll see you in the next one.